Dear ladies and gentlemen, only a few weeks ago, on the International Day of Education, I held a speech outlining my vision for the future of learning in Europe. I demanded more European efforts and a new cross-cutting approach in order to make education more inclusive and ready for the digital age. The chronic investment backlog in the member states and regions, the lack of digital infrastructure in schools and universities, as well as the absence of modern teaching methods and concepts, constitutes major challenges to our education systems, but also to our labor markets. In a digitalized world, new skills and competences are required in order to participate successfully in society. It is therefore necessary that the new generation learn how to use digital devices, how computer programs and apps are working, and so on. While we can observe that politics is still lacking behind in the field of digital education and the provision of the necessary skills for living and working in 2019 and beyond, many civil society organizations and networks are already very committed to tackle these challenges through all kinds of projects. DoIt is one of the very good examples. With the support of the European funding scheme Horizon 2020, this project fosters a culture of proactivity and offers education and training targeted at different learner needs and learning settings. Thanks to DoIt, young people between 6 and 16 years old are empowered to develop important digital, social, and entrepreneurial competences. The project makes, in fact, an important contribution for the development of active citizens and social innovators. So far, the DoIt project is active in 10 EU member states, reaching around 42,000 pupils and 20,000 facilitators in schools, makeup spaces and social enterprises. I think these figures are outstanding and do more than justify the support of the EU. However, politics should not only count on this kind of civil society initiatives. Politicians at all levels urgently have to assume their role and give investments in education a more prominent role in their political agenda. We in the European Parliament are taking this role in innovating education very seriously. In the next period of the Erasmus program, for example, we will most probably be able to triple the general budget. Additionally, there will be a much stronger focus on strategic alliance for innovation and learning, enabling us to fund much more projects such as DoIt. The opening and scaling up of the Erasmus program is a step in the right direction. However, if we consider the scale of the problem in education and the labor market, they are far from sufficient. Europe needs more to do if it does not want to waste the huge talent and potential of the younger generation. Thank you very much for your attention and the great job you are doing. Thank you.